into the woods and out of the woods and home before.
There are giants in the sky. There are big, tall, terrible giants in the sky. When you're way up high and you look below at the world you left and the things you know, little more than a glance is enough to show you just how small you are. When you're way up high and you're on your own in a world like none that you've ever known, where the sky is lead and the earth is stone, you're free to do whatever pleases you, exploring things you never dare, cause you don't care when suddenly there's a big, tall, terrible giant at the door. A big, tall, terrible lady giant sweeping the floor. She gives you food and she gives you rest, and she draws you close to her giant breast, and you know things now that you never knew before. Not till the sky. Only just when you've made a friend and all, and you know she's big but you don't feel small, someone bigger than her comes along the hall to swallow you for lunch. And your heart is lead and your stomach's stone, and you're really scared being all alone. And it's then that you long for the things you've known and the world you left, all the little you own. The fun is done. You steal what you can and run. And you scramble down and you look below, and the world you know begins to grow. The roof, the house, and your mother at the door. The roof, the house, and the world you never thought to explore. And you think of all of the things you've seen, and you wish that you could live in between. And you're back again, only different than before. After the sky, there are giants in the sky. There are big, tall, terrible, awesome, scary, wonderful giants in the sky. Good fortune. Good fortune, sir. Look what I have. Here are 5 gold pieces.
5 gold pieces?
I had more, but my mother made me surrender them. She allowed me these 5 to do with as I pleased.
Oh, my.
Where is Milky White?
Milky White is back home with my wife.
Let's go find them.
Oh, no, no. I don't know that I wish to sell.
You said that I might buy her back.
I know, but I don't know that 5 gold pieces...
Are you saying that you wish more money?
More money.
Keep this, and I will go fetch more.
Oh, no, 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 wait. Wait. I didn't say that I would... Five gold pieces. With this money, I could buy baking supplies for a year. I could buy a new thatched
roof. What could you buy yourself, a child?
Who are you?
When first I appear, I seem delirious. When explained, I'm nothing serious. Would you buy yourself a child?
I don't understand.
How badly do you wish a child? 5 gold pieces? 10? 20?
I've not thought to put a price on
it. Exactly. You've not thought about many things, have you, son?
Oh, give me back the money that is not yours.
Yours are Jack's.
The money is not what's important. What's important is that your wish be honored.
But I want the money back. Come back here. What are you doing here now?
I see you have the red cape.
Yes! Yes, I've the cape! I've only 2 items left to locate.
3.
2. I've the cow and the cape.
You have the cape.
What have you done with the cow?
She ran away before I reached home. I have been looking for her all night.
I should have known better than to have entrusted her to you.
She might just as easily have run from you.
But she didn't.
Well, she might have.
But she didn't.
Cow.
She did not run.
Okay.
We were just going to do that. Look, I could give you this.
I don't want to touch that fool. Have no sense.
My sweet Miss Cole, she's over there. By tomorrow's midnight, Deliver the items, or you'll wish you never thought to have a child.
Help!
Oh. I don't like that woman.
I'm sorry that I lost the cow.
Yes, yes, I shouldn't have yelled. And now please go back to the village. Yes. Quickly, please. I will make things right. And then we can just go about our lives. No more hunting in the woods for strange objects. No more witches, or dim-witted boys, or hungry little girls.
Go!
Ah, there you are, good brother. Father and I had wondered where you had gone.
I've been looking all night for her.
Her?
Yes. The beautiful one I danced the evening with.
Well, where did she go?
I disappeared. Like the fine morning mist.
Well, she was lovely.
The loveliest. Oh,
I'm not certain of that. I must confess, I too have found a lovely maiden. She lives here in the woods.
The woods?
Yes, in the top of a tall tower that has no door or stairs.
Where?
2 leagues from here, due east, just beyond the mossy knoll.
And how do you manage a visit?
Oh, I stand before her window and I say, Rapunzel, Rapunzel, let down your hair to me. And then she lowers the longest, most beautiful head of hair, yellow as corn, which I climb to her.
Rapunzel, Rapunzel, what kind of a name is that?
You jest. I have never heard of such a thing.
I speak the truth.
And she is as true as your maiden, a maiden running from a prince. None would run from us.
Yet one has. Did I abuse her or show her disdain? Why does she run from me? If I should lose her, how shall I regain the heart she has won from me? Agony beyond power of speech, when the one thing you want is the only thing out of your reach.
High in her tower, she sits by the hour, maintaining her hair. Blithe and becoming, and frequently humming a light-hearted air. Ah,
agony far more painful than yours. When you know she would go with you if there only were doors. Agony. What's as intriguing or half so fatiguing as what's out of reach? Am I not sensitive, clever, well-mannered, considerate, passionate, charming, as kind as I'm handsome and heir to a throne?
You are everything maidens could wish for.
Then why no?
Do I know?
The girl must be mad. You know nothing of madness till you're climbing her hair, and you see her up there as you're nearing her, all the while hearing her agony, misery, though it's different for each. Always 10 steps behind,
always 10 feet below,
and she's just out of reach. Agony that can cut like a knife. I must have her to wife.
Is each more handsome than the other. No, get the hair.
Excuse me, young woman.
Have you encountered a boy with carrot top hair and a sunny
though occasionally vague disposition, answering to the name of Jack.
Not the one partial to a white cow?
He's the one.
Have you seen the cow?
No, and I don't care to ever again. Children can be very queer about their animals. You be careful with your children.
I have no children.
That's okay, too.
Yes, well, I'm sorry. Very sorry. I've not seen your son today.
I hope he didn't go up that beanstalk again. Quit while you're ahead, I say. Jack! Jack!
Moo. Moo.
Moo. Looking for your cow.
Yeah. Where did you find her? Hello? Hello?
What are you doing?
I'm here to make amends.
I want you to stay out of this, old man.
I'm here to see that you get your wish.
You have caused enough trouble. You keep out of my path. Yeah!
Oh, and now let's see. If that was the mossy knoll, then this must be the tower. Oh, I certainly hope there are no witches to be encountered here. Rapunzel, Rapunzel, let down your hair to me.
Is that you, my prince?
Yes. Oh, my. Oh. Yeah. Oh, excuse me for this.
Ah!
Oh. My goodness, you do take plenty of spills, don't you?
It's these slippers. They're not suited for these surroundings. Actually, they're not much suited for dancing either.
I'd say these slippers were as pure as gold.
Oh, yes, they are all you could wish for in beauty.
Oh, what I wouldn't give for just one.
Well, one is not likely to do you much good.
Was the ball just as wonderful as last evening?
Oh, it's still a nice ball.
Yes, and?
And they have far too much food.
No, the prince.
Oh, the prince.
Yes, the prince.
If he knew who I really was.
Oh,
who? I'm afraid I was rude.
Oh, how?
Now I'm being pursued.
Yes, and?
And I'm not in the mood.
Oh, he must really have taken a liking to you.
Oh, yes, but I have no experience with princes and castles and gowns and things.
Oh, nonsense. Every girl dreams of just those things.
There.
You would be so...
Are you
so
you
oh, please,
stop! No, no, I need you to get me out of here!
Where did she go?
Who? Oh,
don't play the fool, woman.
Oh, yes, of course. I'm sorry. You mean the beautiful, the maiden,
yes.
the maiden in the ball gown.
Yes,
she went in that direction. I was trying to hold her here for you.
I can capture my own damsel. Thank you.
Oh, where did he go?
Who?
The prince, of course.
That direction, you'll never reach him.
Oh, well, we would have if that mongrel with the cow hadn't molested us.
Oh, please. Please, let me just compare this color to that of your own, please. I thought you were returning home. I've had no luck.
You've the cow.
Yes, I've the cow. I've only two of the four.
Three.
Two.
Three. Compare this to your corn.
Where did you find it?
I pulled it from a maiden in a tower.
Three.
Oh, and I almost had the fourth, but she got away.
We've an entire day left. Surely we can find the slipper by then.
We? You mean you'll allow me to stay?
Perhaps it will take the two of us to get this child.
You've changed. You're daring. You're different in the woods. More sure, more sharing. You're getting us through the woods. If you could see, you're not the man who started, and much more open-hearted than I knew you to be.
It takes two. I thought one was enough. It's not true. It takes two of us. You came through. When the journey was rough, it took you. It took two of us. It takes care. It takes patience and fear and despair to change. Though you swear to change, you can tell if you do. It takes two.
You've changed. You're thriving. There's something about the woods. Not just surviving. You're blossoming in the woods. At home, I'd fear we'd stay the same forever. And then, out here, you're passionate, charming, considerate, clever.
It takes one to begin, but then once you've begun, it takes two of you. It's no fun, but what needs to be done, you can do. When there's two of you, if I dare, it's because I'm becoming aware of us as a pair of us. It's accepting a share of what's there.
We've changed. We're strangers. I'm meeting you in the woods. Who minds what dangers? I know we'll get past the woods. And once we're past, let's hope the changes last. Beyond woods, beyond witches and slippers and hoes, just the two of us, beyond lies, safe at home with our beautiful prize. Just a few of us, it takes trust. It takes just a bit more and we're done. We want four, we have none, we've got three. We need one, it takes two.
My milky white and the owners and my hand.
Oh! Oh, look what this hen has dropped in my hands.
A golden egg.
Yes.
I've never seen a golden egg.
You see, I promised you more than the 5 gold pieces I gave you, sir.
5 gold pieces?
Now I'm taking my cow.
5 gold pieces?
I never said I would sell.
You took the 5 gold pieces.
You took 5 gold pieces?
No, I did not take. You gave.
Where are the 5 gold pieces?
There was this mysterious old man.
What are you saying?
I could have my money. I can see this.
Milky White is dead.
Oh, two.
Two. Midnight's gone.
Wanting a boss, not wanting a prince.
Near may be better than far, but it still isn't there.
Near may be better than far, but it still isn't there.
The ball.
You can never love somebody else's child.
Midnight's
the
gone.
Way you love.
The greatest prize can often lie at the end of a thorniest path.
Two midnights gone.
Two midnights gone.
Two midnights gone.